the fan. I got two.
Matthew Edmonds, last fight was a British title challenge. He was stopped in seven by Gary Davis. He's busy, throws a lot of shots, but he can be caught. He's taking on Martin Power, former British champion who defended his crown twice before vacating it. He's much more experienced. We can join this one from the start.
Well, here's an intriguing one. Matthew Edmonds in the black and gold, former British title contender, in with former British champion Martin Power from Camden Town, for who things have gone pretty wrong with only one win out of six recently. Needs a win here. And this is a crossroads fight of a sort, really. And for the loser, the signs will point towards obscurity, I think.
Yeah, very important for Power, who is a former British champion who's just slipped after good wins in his career. Points wins over Dale Robinson, Ian Nabra. But he's slipped quite a bit down since then.
And he lost a rematch with Ian Nabra and stopped in eight by Stuart Hall in Brentwood. There was a defeat against Gary Davis as well. Power has to try to rediscover the power tonight. And is it deal or no deal for Edmonds? Good right hand from him there.
Edmonds has had similar problems. So it's an all-important fight for both these men.
He's coming off a British title loss in seven rounds to Gary Davis in April, is Matthew Edmonds. He's from Newport, plenty of his fans in tonight, hoping he can get what would be a big win, but it'll take some getting. I think it's significant, you know, here, Glenn, that both of them have weighed in at 8 stone 6 pounds on the bantamweight limit, as if it was a championship fight.
Well, it might be a championship fight to these two. It means
nothing will be fought like a championship fight. Certainly started like that. Both of them letting the leather fly in this opening round.
Throwing a few more punches. Edmonds has had good success with clean right hands.
Nice and quick there, though. Martin Power trying to stay away as Edmonds tries to exert pressure. Good burst there, Power fires back again. And you just sense the crowd beginning to be engrossed in the plot of this one. Look at these exchanges in the opening round.
Yeah, Edmonds looking over Power. Power.
Very, very fired up. Both of these two, they know what's on the line. It's good pressure from Edmonds in this opening session.
Yeah, he's done well second half of this round. Edmonds, just to look the boss in there.
Body shot as well, with Power having to fight with his back to the ropes as he had to for a fair bit of that round.
Freshen it.
Started quite well, Power, but Edmonds, second half, just started to try and match him for Power and pushed him back seconds. Using his strength. I was just getting the better of it.
Here's the second round of this one. The black and gold of local man Matthew Edmonds. Still only 25. Power's 4 years older now at 29. And often the fighters at these lower weights tend to peak earlier on in their career, whereas the heavies these days seem to be hitting their best around 30. Unlikely to be any shortage of action in this one, as long as it goes.
Now Edmonds looking to plant his feet, really drive in, hard punches.
Good right hands on the counter from Power. That's the risk for Edmonds, and he makes mistakes on the way in. He has to be a little cute with the pressure. Covering up well, counter punching from Power. That's his tactic. Good right hand there, a couple of them in fact from Edmonds, and a body shot as well.
He really is pushing Power, isn't he? And Power is having to work hard in defense.
It's an all-action contest. Gotta be accurate with these. A little wild, very wild in fact, Edmonds, with that. Hardly anything landed of about 8 punches then.
But he does look physically strong, doesn't he? He wants to make an impression here, Edmonds.
I think he's one of those super fit operators. That's the word in the gym about Matthew Edmonds. Worth remembering that he beat Kevin Mitchell, who had that great win over Bradis Prescott, and Don Broadhurst, who's in tonight's top of the bill, who's a Commonwealth champion in the amateurs. Those are good wins, and he just looks so insistent here. He's just trying to drive the fight out of Martin Power.
Well, he's drawing Power into a fight, isn't he? I'm not sure that really suits Power. He's probably a better boxer, but he needs to use the ring, move, use straight punches.
He's got to box his way to victory. Otherwise, there's a danger over 6 rounds that Edmonds will just hustle him out of this. Good right hand. Oh! They got him going there, right to the temple, and then went right through to the boxing boots of Edmonds, that shot. And his legs splayed, and he did that silly dance. Well, interesting, to put it mildly.
Yeah, that's good Power, an awful lot of confidence. You know he can hurt Edmonds now.
And he's touched down. He's touched down. It's going to have to be a count here. Edmonds suddenly is the fighter on the back foot. Takes an 8 count. Power turning things around, having been under pressure, a little bit careless. Another one landed to the temple. Edmonds wants to hold on. Buy some time. He needed that bell. He needed it badly.
He just walked on the punches there. Trying to use his strength and marching forward. But then a casual little right hand, really. Short little right hook. Didn't look a powerful punch, but it had the legs all over the place.
Just caught him on the temple, didn't it? And a lot of fighters will tell you that that can have a very disorientating effect.
Then the knockdown, another good right hand. This time catching him on the right side of the jaw. But I'm not sure he's fully recovered.
But he's trying
a little bit late there.
I mean, he was well down, wasn't he, by the time Power was trying to land the last one. Didn't really land it cleanly, but he knew what he was doing. His round 3, Powers in the blue trunks. Matthew Edmonds was a minute long enough for him to get his senses back together again.
Changed tactics a bit now, hasn't he, Edmonds?
Well, I think that's made him think, hasn't it? I think it's made his corner think as well. Just obeying my instructions, says referee David Walters, to both of them. They both want this so very, very badly. Both coming off defeats and important fights. Both looking for the way back towards the top in the domestic bantamweight division.
Yeah, whoever loses slips back, don't they?
Slips back further.
Yeah. All important.
Good right hand again from Power, and a left as well. That one just made the knees bend too. He's starting to set his feet for some of these. Power looks like the one with the power of these two. He looks the puncher of these two.
Well, he's regained a little bit of form, isn't he, Martin Power?
And you can see the confidence coursing through his veins almost here, really, now. Hard to know why it kind of went wrong for Power, but it certainly did. Another right hand again. Edmonds in some trouble here.
Yeah, these punches on the side of the head are having an effect on Edmonds. Good fight this, though. We thought it would be.
Step back. Power knows that he can hit and hurt Edmonds now, and that's what he's looking for. Good little comeback from Edmonds.
He used quite a bit of energy part.
The pressure from Edmonds when it's come has been a little manic and slapped a little by way of punch picking and control. And Power's done better in those two departments. Look at him, he's throwing this leather, but how much of it is actually getting through? Power breaks out of the shell and tries to nail him with a right hand again.